I remember it just being really exciting to fall in love with him. Ian could get serious if need be, but humor was the basis of pretty much any conversation.
Good.
It was just fun to be together. To be around somebody that had that much life.
Good morning, lovey. I made you waffles and coffee. What?
I'm a lovey.
I'm your lovey.
I'm a lovey.
I must love you?
Yeah.
I do. Yeah. Good morning. We developed that on September 21st, 2006, which was 9 days before your accident.
Ian and Larissa Murphy met in college and fell in love. Their Christian faith, a daily commitment to Christ, had always been at the heart of their relationship, and they planned to get married as soon as they finished school.
Look at that one. That's from the lake, too.
But 10 months into their relationship, on his way to work, Ian lost control of his car and veered into oncoming traffic. Ian spent months in a coma with a traumatic brain injury. When he finally woke up, the man Larissa loved was now trapped inside a damaged brain and a broken body.
It's great.
It's great.
There's intense grief and there's intense pain. And I would have moments of struggling with, God, why us? Are we being punished for something?
To know wisdom and instruction, to understand words of insight.
One of the hardest things is just watching couples walk together and hold hands. And I'll look at that and think, I'll never do that. Sometimes, like, I come home and I feel like all I see is the brain injury, instead of seeing a man who loves me.
It is an unimaginable trial for a young couple, a test of their love and a test of their faith.
You may now kiss the bride. It is my pleasure to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ian Murphy.